related to the talks that happened. So if there's a question that you have, say, directed to one particular speaker, you can ask them, or if it's a general question, either of them can ask. So just keep it sort of in context with what the first three this was. So anyone to start with.
Raise your hand. Who's the school? Please tell me the first one, the first lucky.
Yeah, so we are actually building a new project which is quite complex, and the packing structure is quite defined as the REST API based microservices. And on UI side, we are about to we are looking forward a stack like whether to use Redux or we have explored middleware as well, or the Apollo or the Relay model. So we are quite confused as the on the backend. It is basically microservices, which doesn't have a GraphQL wrapper. But my question is that should we use GraphQL client here on the client side? Is it possible to use or
So we actually used GraphQL to the client side. So I thought this is quite closer to GraphQL. In our application, for example, in our company, we have enterprise APIs, so it's quite a huge one, and every API is kind of it's a microservices system, so there are separate teams managing each API. And so we have two options, as you said, either we go the imperative way or the declarative way. So this is actually the kind of shift that the programming world is actually going towards today. As we also mentioned today in the morning, we move from imperative way to the declarative way, and we move from jQuery to React. Similarly, on the client, like API side also, the Redux is more on the declarative part, wherein whatever that we are using, either Saga or Tuck, you have to always say, okay, now do this call to the API, get auto response and give back the data, do this kind of massaging on the data and then return kind of things that you have to specifically say. And on Apollo GraphQL, it is more declarative. You just say that, okay, for this component, this is the query. I don't really care about how the data comes and it should just come and show up. That is, I feel that is kind of the one which is going for future, because while you want to handle complexity, a declarative way is much better to go. The way we have done it in GraphQL is we get the enterprise API as is, within cluster. We just created a separate GraphQL server, which is kind of standing in between my client and the API. And it is kind of a facade to all the API. So I just make a call that, okay, I want these details. It is my GraphQL's concern to say that, okay, to get these details, probably I have to hit like 2-3 different API, get the data, put it together and send it back. And then you can do some performance optimization, like if I keep the GraphQL server very near to my API, let's say in the same data center, then the communication between them is quite fast. So you don't really have to face problems with, you know, network mode, network hubs, because of this kind of integration.
It's a REST API. REST API. So right now I feel like Apollo is good for GraphQL. It is also good for REST API also. But you have to add extra additional server things to make REST to GraphQL. And if you say it is really complex, like it updates, if you update one thing, it updates like around 10 to 20 things. Up your state, you can use Mobix or something else. And again, if you want to completely move on to GraphQL in the future, it's preferred to use something.
Okay,
yes.
Next question.
There was a very nice question that I got very recently. I was presenting this context API in one of the meetups in Bangalore. I took it like for this half an hour, the same thing that I talked about there. After everything was done, one guy came to me and he said, what is context API?
So my question to Swami. So
need a distracting.
Yeah, so can you can a component be a provider and a consumer?
Yeah, so the condition is that you
just and the other one, can you use ReactNative, sorry, Redux in tandem with the context API, or it is meant as an alternative to it?
Yeah. So, the only, my eyes are all on the chocolate. The only condition is that your consumers have got to be inside your provider, because if they are outside your provider, the call like it goes outward, right? So, like, consumer has got to be with the provider so that he knows who the provider is, otherwise it will not really get. And that is where we had this default state that I showed you in the API. I said that okay, while you create for the create context, you can also provide a default value. That is in this kind of fallback situations, like let's say if you have a consumer, you don't have a provider, what is it that it is going to provide you? It will provide you in such cases the default value which is given. But a clean business directly have your provider and inside that all your consumers. So that is why generally even when you are working with let's say router or readers, we would always have all our providers at the application level. Right? So we'll have all of them wrapping the application so that now you are kind of you know that any kind of consumers inside, they will be inside of you. So what is the second question?
Can you use React, sorry, Redux along with
Context API? So, definitely. So, also, although Redux internally uses context, but as we saw that you can actually create multiple contexts within your applications. Right? Even if you have your own context, you can also have Redux handling its own state management. So, a situation where you have Redux as well as your context API will probably be an example of theming, let's say. It all depends upon the design of your application. If you want to say that Redux will store only my application's state, when I say application state, only the data which is related to my application. So ultimately, what exactly is React doing? It's all a game of data, right? Your data is just flowing between the servers and the users, and all these front-end frameworks, they are just kind of making it visually look good to the user. So all your components are nothing but data looking good to you. So if you say that I want to handle only application related data in my Redux store, you can do that. And then you can say that these kind of cross-cutting concerns, like let's say internationalization, theming and all, you handle separately. So you can have both of them sitting together.
Okay, next.
Yeah, so this question is quite, I think this is just an extension of the question that you asked. So in your talk you said the difference between Redux and the context API. So you said Redux has more tools and all. So apart from that, is there any advantage of context API or Redux, like any performance and all? So like in one of our projects, we are using Redux. So will it make sense if I remove complete Redux and use context API there?
So Redux, although it internally uses context API, it is not just a wrapper over context API. Right? For example, its concept of a single store, or the concept of using pure functions for reducers, right? So there is a lot of things like an entire new design that they have come up with. It is just that they are using context API as an enabler to do it. So if you can write a code which is you know, as good as that, let's say if it serves your purpose, it is actually not a very big library, it's a very small piece of code. If you can do that, then you can have your own. But definitely, when it is actually a general question of when do I use a library versus when do I do my own. Right? Most of the time, if you have a library which is serving your purpose, it is always good to use a library because see the number of places where this library has been wide tested. Right? Like a lot of people in the industry are already using it. There are so many contributors to it, so it has been very well tested in a lot of different situations. So your application will actually end up being much more stable and not having hiccups if you are using a good standard library. But if you are confident about what you are doing, and let's say a lot of times a library provides this much and you only need this much, in such cases you can do your own.
Okay, I have a question for Chakravarti. So what do you suggest if an API call is failing, can we use L boundaries for that?
You can use it.
Okay.
All you have to do is, you have to close the error.
Have you been using it for production, like in production?
No.
Next, I think someone, Ritesh?
I don't have any direct React question. I just have a general question. I have a mobile app, but not a web developer. So what we are exploring is the possibility of best text time that we can use from React. When I compare the performance, Flutter seems to go very up in the performance side. But when I compare the sizes, React go up in the size. So what would be your opinion on that, Flutter, which technology will be best for mobile, not for Flutter?
Flutter is very new. One thing in software is you cannot get everything. Like if you have, you must compromise on performance, or else you must compromise on speed, whatever. You must compromise on at least one thing. we cannot create everything in software. So if you really want to make the job done easily, choose React Native. If you have the power of native developers, use native. That's it. It depends on what you have, what the resources you have. Mostly, rather than if you try to train your people into something else, it takes more time, more energy, and I'm pretty sure it won't be like the same application with the developers who have the same experience with other technologies.
One more question here.
Last two questions.
This question is related to context API again. So you mentioned saying we can use context API when we are doing teamings and we are doing localizations. On the same lines, let's say we have an application which not just changes the fonts and the theme, but also certain DOM elements are also changed, and we need two separate starting for the login page in that application. So in terms of that, does context API also have a limitation that we could use that it is defined up to, that we cannot use an entire application inside a context API or differentiate between themings using a context API?
So context API by itself is just like an empty room. So it doesn't really care about what you put inside the room and how you use that. So it doesn't really give any kind of restriction on how you can use it or in what purpose you should use it. It's just such a restriction that there has to be a provider who will provide the data, and then whoever are the consumers, I'll just let them know. So let's say this is more like, I think, a responsive design probably, right? Like let's say you want to show your application differently on a tab, differently on a...
No, it's basically two different applications.
Okay.
Using same functionalities, but few CSS changes, few theming changes, plus few DOM elements. Like for example, for the login page, we have extra buttons in this application, but on this application, we will not have the login button. Something like this. So in this case, you would have to maintain two separate contexts. So you would be putting the entire data of one particular application in that particular context. So the red phrase,
Sorry to disturb you. Can you guys take it offline during the lunch time? Okay. We are running out of the time. Sorry.
Last one.
Hi, this is a question for Dipti. How do you start, or what's the right model to make developers not writing React code, say coming from an Angular or a Java background, to start thinking in components and the React style of the way?
You can use it. So actually when I came from a jQuery background, I really didn't start immediately with React. I got to know about like functional thing which was going on. I just checked out the how functional thing works, and I just saw the implementation of it in React, and that was one of the motivation for me to learn React. Then to think in terms of component. It was really hard for me to think in terms of component. I cannot, because agar design a page data hai, so I just start yes header, usi baat slider dalo. I never think like yeah. इसमें डिवाइड करते हैं I just keep on doing it. But yeah, when I just saw this kind of a change, it really made me think, and that was one of the reason that I think that's your question, right? Yeah, that is one of the reason I come up with React and learning things. Yeah.
So I think that's it. Thank you all the speakers for answering the question, and thank you guys for asking. We have again the joint Q&A after two talks, so.
Yeah.
And
if you have more questions, you can
say hi to me. And give feedback.